I've made a copy of ODB43. That one still has all the departments and groups, and I'm calling this one ODB45 More About Constraints. In this video, we're going to look at how a constraint affects other values, specifically the null value, or as displayed on the LibreOffice GUI screens as the required value. A few videos back, we saw that if we had null values in the department ID or group ID on the employee table, we needed to do a left outer join to be sure we've selected all the employees on that table. An easy way to get around the left outer join is to set the entry required field to yes. In other words, make it so null values are not allowed. This sounds like a quick and easy fix, so I'm going to go into tables and right click on the employees table, edit. I'm going to come down to the department ID. I'm going to come down to entry required and change that to yes. So far it looks good, but when I click the save, we get this warning that the column department ID could not be changed. Should the column instead be deleted in a new format appended, I'll say yes. Here we get the error, column is referenced from the constraint FK department ID, foreign key department ID. That's the foreign key that we assigned. What this message is telling us is we need to delete the foreign key, then we can update this field, then we can reassign the foreign key. When I close this window, this is asking us if we want to save the changes. We do not. I'll say no. And we want to go to our Tools Relationships window. From here, we looked at this relationship in the last video, so I'm going to select it and delete it. Save our relationships. Close the window. Back on our employee table, I'm going to right click, edit, selecting department ID. Now we can change this entry required to yes. I'll save this. Close. It's asking us if we want to save the changes. I say yes. Let's go back to our relationships window. Tools, relationships. Department ID to department ID. We want to create a new one. Update cascade and set to default. When I click OK, we get an error. This is the same problem we had in the last video. The problem is, let me close here, cancel out. I'll close this. If I go back and open up and edit, come down to department, when we recreated this department ID, it did put yes into the entry required, but we had zero as our default value, and since this is incorrect, it rewrote the default value and put in nulls. I'm going to come over to the tools, open up the SQL command window, and I've got some SQL here that will alter the table employees, alter the column department ID, make this an integer, default 0, not null. And this is basically what we need the GUI to do, but for some reason this default value is not being set properly. I'm going to paste this here and execute. It ran okay. Now I'm going up to Tools, Relationships. We should be able to set this department ID. Create a new one, make this update cascade, set to default, and it works well. That worked so well, I want to do the whole thing this time from a single execute, from a single file. To do that, we need to know what the foreign key constraint name is. To get that, I'm going to come back here to Queries. I'm going to come down to ODB43A System Tables, edit that in SQL view. I've reformatted this query to make it easier to read. Let's run it. And I'm going to take off the public and rerun it. Looking at the table names, we see we've got about 50 columns. We can go through and look at each and every column, or you can also do an internet search to find out which table that would be in. I've already done that, and I've seen that it will be in the System Cross Reference. So I'm going to change this to System Cross Reference and run this query. This shows us our primary key table name, primary key column, foreign key table name, foreign key column. We've got our foreign key name, and if you look at this foreign key group ID, this is the one that we set. The system foreign key 137, this is the foreign key name that LibreOffice created. If we look at the update rule and delete rule, these are by numbers, and 0 is cascade, a 1 is constraint long restrict, 2 is set null, 3 is no action, and 4 is set to default. So we see that these two are set to default. Department ID, that's the one that we just created. The group ID, that has got this foreign key group ID. This is the one that we're going to delete and recreate. And I've got some SQL here to do just that. We're going to drop the foreign key group ID constraint. We're going to alter the table to make group ID integer default 0, not null. Then we're going to recreate this constraint. I'm going to select this all. Go into Tools, SQL, Control V to paste. I've got my three commands. Well, those are the comments. One command, that I've got my semicolon to separate them. When I click Execute, it shows me one command successfully executed. And when I run the System Columns query, it will show us group ID and department ID. Both have no in the is nullable column, so they cannot be null. When we look at our relationships window, these are set back the way we had them. If I edit, we see it's set default and update cascade. We're going to save this query as ODB45 cross-reference. I'll close this window and save the database.